If you would like to support the channel, then please turn off adblock and refresh the page. Alternatively, use the link in the description below to donate to T1 Patreon. Thank you. Hello, Magic Community on YouTube. I'm T1 Glistener Elf, just hanging around for a little bit. I wanted to do a quick deck tech because this is Christopher Long's deck tech that he got for supporting me on Patreon. It is about Devoted Druid. That's the card that he selected. Now, this one is a long time in the making, sort of. It's actually not. So he asked for this long enough ago that at the time, Devoted Druid was not really that much of a thing in Modern. We had a player in our store named Kevin Page who went to an SCG Classic and came in 19th, which is pretty cool. I saw him one day and I kept coming back to Tapstar, trying to catch him again. But lo and behold, I couldn't. He hasn't been there since. So that delayed this interview with him that was supposed to be part of the deck tech for long enough that it's exploded. You know what Devoted Druid does now, it's been that long. So it's hard for me to do a deck tech on the full deck itself. Before I go on, I should probably make sure that we're all on the same page. Devoted Druid is a 2-mana creature, it's a mana dork. It taps to make green, but you can untap it by putting a -1/-1 counter on it. Okay, well enough. Vizier of Remedies from Amonkhet makes it where if you would put a -1/-1 counter, you put one fewer of them. So if you would put one, you put none. So you can untap this infinitely, so you can make infinite mana. That's all well and good. In and of itself, it's kind of similar to the Malira combo in that Malira plus Kitchen Finks plus Vicsera Seer is a 3-card combo. Devoted Druid plus Vizier is not enough on its own. You need an outlet. This need for an outlet is why the deck runs Duskwatch Recruiter. So on its own, it's already pretty nice, right? It's a bear that can transform and it has an ability on both sides. That's pretty good. But it has an outlet that lets you go and add creatures to your hand. Dump infinite mana, get all the creatures out of your deck, and from there it's a bit of a choose your own adventure, and this deck has two main ways of doing that. The first is with a, well, Walking Ballista. Yeah, invect creatures hate this thing. Once you have infinite mana, you put infinite, and anytime I say infinite, that means arbitrarily high number, so 1 million. I can't get my finger up to my mouth now. You put 1 million counters on it and then throw 1 million damage at their face. Well and good. Rhonas the Indomitable from Amonkhet is another one. Infinite green mana, give all of your creatures infinite power. Okay. So, and then everything else in the deck is built around there, like Noble Hierarch ramps you, Simian Spirit Guide, if you run that, ramps you, etc. It should be noted that since this is a white deck, it can run Path to Exile for interaction, but more importantly, since it's a green deck, and since it's a combo deck, it can run Chord of Calling and Collected Company, so that makes this an awfully consistent deck. When you consider Devoted Druid to be a ramp creature, plus Noble Hierarch, plus Simian Spirit Guide, you can get up to 4 mana awfully quickly, and since it's a core deck, you can also go for your little one-ups like Spellskite or Reclamation Sage or Kasali Pride Mage, etc. that can help to protect your combo or disrupt the opponent. Now, I'm in a bit of a tough position because on the one hand, I actually very much like Kevin Page's list. On the other hand, I was asked to do a Devoted Druid deck tech and just simply making somebody else's. Just talking about it, it's not very... I don't think this is what Christopher would want. You can go and see Star City Games featured Kevin Page's list, but I want to do a different take. And the way that I decided to go about it, first let's start with a little bit of discussion. Walking Ballista, why is it a 4 of? Remember, this is a Chord and CoCo deck. But if you try to Chord or CoCo for Walking Ballista, what happens? Well, it it dies. It's a 0/0. So having 4 isn't all that useful. Having 1 is fine because you can get it with Duskwatch Recruiter. Having 4 makes it more likely you'll naturally be able to go off when you have all that mana from Devoted Druid. However, Walking Ballista has another advantage that Kevin spoke to me about personally, and that is, if you're playing against a white deck and you go off with Walking Ballista, they might get kind of clever and think, well, wait a minute, I can use Stony Silence and beat them that way. So he'll take out Walking Ballista, at least 3 of them, and bring in Rhonas the Indomitable as an alternate win condition. So that sort of plays mind games with the opponent. That said, at any time other than when it's in your hand naturally or off of Duskwatch Recruiter, it isn't very good. So, as an alternate game plan, what I propose doing is freeing up 7 slots, 3 Walking Ballistas, leaving 1 in the deck, and 4 of something else, which we'll get to in just a second, to add another combo to the list. The deck is already running 1 Anafenza, Kintry Spirit. So, given that, we could run the Kitchen Finks combo. Kitchen Finks, of course, having Persist, gaining infinite life, yada yada. You've seen this in Malira combo, Malira and Company, for ages, it seems. Vizier of Seer is our sac outlet of choice, but that means that we'd have to add another color, and with only 19 lands, that might be a bit of an issue, especially since Noble Hierarch doesn't make black. Going over to Birds of Paradise would make this a little bit more viable. Now, we've given ourselves a creature that can come down off of Collected Company, but we've opened ourselves up to Graveyard Hate. But again, we can do the same thing that's done with Walking Ballista. You side it out to beat Stony Silence, you can side out Kitchen Finks to beat Rest in Peace and other such cards, Surgical Extraction, etc. While the times that you'd want to Chord for a Walking Ballista on its own aren't that common, after all, once you have infinite mana, you Chord for Duskwatch and then get everything in your deck, you know, now it isn't an option, now you can Chord for a Kitchen Finks. Now, if we're taking out 3 Walking Ballistas but putting in 7 creatures, 4 Kitchen Finks and 3 Vizier of Seer, we have to take out 4 of something else. As much as it might hurt, Simeon Spirit Guide is the one that I'm having go for this one. We're adding more combo redundancy, but we're reducing speed. Is that okay? Given that Simeon Spirit Guide was only ever a pure ramp creature, the way that Modern's metagame is shaping, that's probably better, but if it ever slows down, I'd rather have more redundancy. Of course, the mana base will have to be adjusted accordingly, and I'll leave a link to both Kevin Page's decklist and this sample decklist of mine in the description below. That said, before all the blood rushes to my head, I'm T1 Glistener Elf. I do this. Signing off, whoa! I will see you all later. Bye-bye.